Heavenly Father, we come to you today with gratitude in our hearts for all the many blessings that you have bestowed upon us. For your word tells us that every good gift and every perfect gift is from above and comes down from the Father of lights. I thank you, Lord, for the outstanding leadership and care that Colonel Turner and his lovely wife have provided the soldiers and families of Fort Gordon Garrison. Their time here in Fort Gordon is ending, and they are moving to new places where you've called them to serve. We ask that you keep your hand of grace on them as they head out to face the new challenges of a new mission. I thank you, Lord, that you have continued to bless Fort Gordon with great leadership. As Colonel Clifford assumes command today, grant abundant blessing upon him and his family. I ask, Lord, that you give him the wisdom to understand the difficult and the complex, the courage to weather every storm and challenge with integrity, the strength to finish every task with excellence, and the compassion needed to lead soldiers and families during this time of uncertainty and change. I pray also for Colonel Clifford's family. Give them, Lord, the strength to weather the unpredictable and demanding parts of this mission, as well as a joyful spirit to enjoy all of its ups and downs. I ask your blessing for the men and the women of Fort Gordon Garrison, as well as their families. May your strength enable us to protect others. May your providence keep us safe from harm. And may your presence turn our hearts towards you each and every day. In your holy name I pray. Amen. Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. At this time, flowers are being presented to Mrs. Becky Turner by Specialist Okechukwu, the Garrison Soldier of the Year. She is receiving a bouquet of red roses. Red is the color of the heart and reflects the loving concern that she has shown for soldiers and civilians of the Garrison and their families over the past 2 years. Mrs. Turner's roses are in full bloom, symbolizing the beauty and fulfillment of her time with us as the First Lady of the United States Army Garrison, Fort Gordon. Colonel Turner's son, Blake, is also receiving a token of gratitude from the soldiers and civilians of the Garrison. Being presented to Mrs. Hannah Clifford, who is receiving a bouquet of yellow rosebuds. Yellow is the color of new beginnings and symbolizes her arrival as the new First Lady of the United States Army Garrison, Fort Gordon. In time, Mrs. Clifford's rosebuds will blossom, as will her relationships with the soldiers and civilians and their families. Colonel Clifford's daughter, Abigail, his mother, Patricia, and mother-in-law, Delia, are also receiving the bouquet. Colonel Clifford's son, Jimmy, is receiving a Garrison coin as a token of welcome to the Garrison. From ancient times, armies throughout the world have conducted ceremonies to commemorate victories over enemies, honor comrades in arms, and celebrate special occasions as we are doing today. These ceremonies have added color and pageantry to military life while preserving tradition and stimulating esprit de corps. The Continental Army established the foundation by which our present-day ceremonies are performed, and today's ceremony is an enactment of an Army tradition that is 243 years old. It reaffirms the concept that the Army is perpetuated on time-honored values and traditions and not on the accomplishments of individuals. Today, you will witness a small part of that tradition as the Garrison colors and command authority of the United States Army Garrison, Fort Gordon, are passed from one leader to another. The non-commissioned officer corps has always been the key link between the officers who provide intent and the soldiers and civilians who execute. In recognition of their essential role in the success of the Garrison command, the most senior non-commissioned officer in the Garrison, Command Sergeant Major Charlie Bryant, will assist in the transfer of the Garrison colors. The change of command is a simple, traditional event that is rich with symbolism and heritage. key to the ceremony is the passing of the garrison colors. These garrison colors represent not only the lineage and honor of the garrison command, but also the loyalty and unity of the soldiers and civilians. The garrison colors are the garrison commander's symbol of authority, representing his responsibility to the organization. Wherever the garrison commander is, there are also the garrison colors. The custodian of the garrison colors is the command sergeant major, who is the senior enlisted soldier in the garrison and the principal advisor to the garrison commander. The passing of the garrison colors symbolizes the transfer of authority from the outgoing commander to the incoming commander. The passing of the colors demonstrates to the soldiers and civilians of the unit that the outgoing garrison commander has passed the mantle of responsibility and leadership to the new garrison commander. But this also passes the loyalty of the soldiers and civilians to their new commander. By authority of Army Regulation 600-20, paragraph 2-5, the undersigned assumes command of the United States Army Garrison, Fort Gordon, effective the 17th day of July, 2018, signed James S. Clifford, Colonel, Signal Corps, commanding. Command Sergeant Major Bryant is now passing the garrison colors to Colonel Turner, the outgoing commander, signifying the last official act between the garrison command sergeant major and the garrison commander. Colonel Turner is now passing the colors to Mr. Greatwatt, signifying a successful completion of command. Mr. Greatwatt is now passing the colors to Colonel Clifford, the incoming commander, charging him with the responsibility for the garrison as its new commander. Colonel Clifford is now passing the colors to Command Sergeant Major Bryant, symbolizing his first official act with the Command Sergeant Major and his trust in the unit's non-commissioned officer corps, thus completing the change of command. Ladies and gentlemen, Director of Installation Management Command Training, Mr. Vince Greatwatt.
Thank you for honoring us with your presence this morning. Mayor Davis, General Morrison, General and Mr. Knapper, General Foley, Mr. Kasmer, Mr. Hall, federal, state, local representatives, senior leaders, friends and family of the Gifford and Turner families, and friends of the garrison here at Fort Gordon, Georgia, welcome to this ceremony this morning. My name is Vince Greatwatt. I'm the Director of MCOM Training, and it's my honor and privilege to serve as your host this morning for a change of command ceremony. Today we recognize the achievements of Colonel Todd Turner and his wife Becky, and we welcome the incoming commander, Jim Gifford, and his wife Hannah. I've got plenty to say about the character and contributions of these two outstanding leaders, but I want to start by mentioning a few things about changes of command and transitions of leadership in general. This morning is as much about continuity as it is about change. While we see a change in garrison leadership, you can have no doubt that the garrison team, the soldiers and the civilians, the contractors who work on this installation are not going to lapse in any of what they've done over the past 2 years and the contributions that they've made. They're going to remain engaged, continuing to support this community and with its mission partners serve the soldiers and the families of this wonderful community. You can rest assured the soldiers and civilians won't miss a beat in the execution of their mission. Now, anyone familiar with installation management over the last 10 years knows that it's not for the faint of heart. It's a contact sport where every day is a bit of a challenge and a little bit different than the day before. And so we know that installation management is also critically dependent on teamwork and partnerships. The heart and soul of it is the relationships that are forged with mission partners on and off the installation, because our mission is critical to enable readiness of our Army.